Good evening, everyone, and welcome along to the NZ's Porsche Cup season finale here at Road America, season 1 2022, round 8 of our championship season. It's been an action-packed season of racing once again in the Porsche Supercup cars, and tonight we bid farewell to these cars as we shift towards our brand new season of NZ Super GT4 next season. But tonight it is all about the Porsche Supercup cars. One more round to go here tonight, and it is back to the solo endurance format for the final time this season. And should be in for a great night of racing. Everyone's back on the grid. We've had a couple missing over the last couple of weeks, but we've got another strong grid and another strong lineup of cars tonight to take to Road America for 23 laps, 150 kilometres for the final race of the season. And it's a fantastic way to round out the season back into the solo endurance format. We'll see multiple pit stops tonight as everyone plays strategy to try and work their way throughout the field. You'll see some drivers in the mid-pack going all out because it's the last round of the season. And you'll also see a couple of key championship contenders who will be trying to play out their storylines in the best way possible to see if they will end up as Season 1 2022 champion. Let's have a quick look and see how the points are currently looking heading into tonight's event. 1,831 points out front. Nathan Anderson for MRP Sim Racing. He's pretty much got one hand already on that title. 162 points behind him, however, Darryn Lobb. He's not too far away. If Anderson slips up for whatever reason tonight, Darryn Lobb will be there to pounce. Now, we believe that if Nathan Anderson, if he wins this race, he wins the title. If Darryn Lobb wins the race tonight, however, Nathan has to finish no worse than 11th spot to wrap up the title. So he's got to finish inside the top 10 to be within a chance of the championship. And that's if Anderson has a horror show, which we don't expect to see, but who knows? The final round, anything is at stake. So cars are about to take to Road America for the final time in qualifying for the season. 25 minutes to see who will come out on top here at Road America and grab the final lot of cash for the season. $10 cash up for grabs tonight, as it has been throughout the course of the season. And it's my privilege to welcome back Matt Hayward into the commentary booth. He's been in action racing over the last couple of weeks, and we've dragged him back into the commentary box for the final time this season. Matt, it's great to have you back, and Road America, 23 laps, a long race tonight, should be a great night of racing.
Thanks very much, James, and thanks for having me back in the commentary box. The chair's still nice and warm, which is great to see. Tonight, Road America is going to be an interesting night. It's a very long track, but it does suit the endurance type very well. And these boys, they're going to have their work cut out. It's a very long, open-flowing track, lots of turns, lots of straights. And the thing with this circuit as well, the straights are so long, it's very hard to actually get away from your competitors. So when it comes race time, I expect there to be a whole heap of people in contention, and no one's really going to fly off into the distance. But you'll see a couple of names familiar, like Barry Manon tonight. He certainly took off in the endurance race last time around, halfway through the championship, and he may indeed fly off again tonight. Speaking of flying off, there goes Darryn Lobb off the gravel track already. And he's in for an interesting night being a championship contender, and I can't wait to see what happens.
That's certainly going to be a great night of racing between the MRP teammates, the number 17 Nathan Anderson and the 99 of Darryn Lobb. There's another car goes off exactly the same spot, Stefan McCartain, almost identical in terms of wheel tracks. So these guys pushing very early in qualifying, getting a read on the track temperature, the grip, seeing what's available at the moment, and better to do it early on in the session, especially on your outlap, than during your flyer. So we'll see a couple cars making their way across the stripe now to begin qualifying, and Anderson's going to lead them, and you can see already a bit of that slipstream coming into effect. But I dare say that the Simblex entry there of DeGraaf might just be a little bit too far behind Anderson. But you never know. These cars definitely like to slipstream, and you can certainly gain some time, especially in these qualifying sessions where every tenth counts.
The games have started already. You can see Nathan Anderson right up against the wall coming down the front straight, looking to get as little resistance to the front of that car as possible. And like you said, Dion DeGraaf may be a little bit far back at the moment, but every little bit helps. And we've seen in previous qualifying sessions that, you know, a tenth here and a tenth there really makes a difference.
Yes, certainly does. And often, more ways than not, the qualifying times have been determined by the absolute slimmest of margins. They've gone out to fair decent chunks over the last couple of weeks. But tonight, we should see some pretty good laps here around Road America. It's a great track to do hot laps around. And we've got about 21 and a half minutes of hot lapping to see who will come out on top for the final qualifying session of the season. And here's a familiar look. That's great to have these colours here from Earl Bamber Motorsport. Callum Hedge, the number 17 on the grid tonight as our wildcard entry here for Road America. If you're not familiar with Callum Hedge, he races these 992 cars in real life overseas in Australia as part of the Porsche Carrera Cup Series. So it's great to have a real-world 992 driver on the grid tonight, and it should be fantastic to watch Callum use his real-world skills and apply that on the sim as well. He's pretty quick behind the wheel of the sim as well, so it'd be great to see him up the pointy end. He's not in championship fight, so he'll be gunning for the win tonight for sure. But great to have Earl Bamber Motorsport represented on the grid tonight.
It's amazing to see what we've got available here in the NZ Porsche Supercup. Like, even Marco Giltrap, he was over at Norwell Motorplex with Paul Morris and Shane Van Gisbergen the other day getting some driver coaching. So, you know, you think sim racing might be just a game to some people. She's pretty real for some people as well. And it's great to see that crossover between the two.
So the first times are on the board. Rumour has it we thought that Barry Manon might actually have been starting off the rear of the field tonight. That is certainly not the case. And there's an MRP car that has got all crossed up.
That's Anderson.
Don't know if that's Anderson. I think that was Callum Pratt in the green car.
Oh, and Hunter Robb as well.
And Hunter Robb's gone off in sympathy as well. If his lap hadn't been impeded by Callum Pratt spinning, it definitely has now. But yeah, big moment there for Callum Pratt, but his teammate's gone to the top. So 205.3, that's the fastest time of the night. We saw a 205.5 in practice a little bit earlier on in the evening from Barry Manon, who joins us as another wildcard entry. He, as Matt said, had a fantastic night behind the wheel of the previous Enduro round in round four of the season. Absolutely dominated, and he's starting things off in the same way tonight. Already 0.8 of a second over Stefan McCartain and Matt Stevens, who have posted virtually identical times there.
Yeah, it's great to have Matt Stevens back. He's been over in Australia, over the Formula One Grand Prix and whatnot, so it's good to have him back for the last round of the season. And as we know, Matt Stevens is always a contender for the front. And at the moment, basically got the exact same time as Stefan McCartain, who we're also used to seeing up front. So you can sort of forget about Barry Manon. I think he's got pole position basically wrapped up. It's going to be from position two onwards where the fun's going to begin.
It'll be very interesting to see what sort of times we see from this man right here, the 99 of Darryn Lobb, who we did see join the server a little bit late. We were starting to throw the question about whether Darryn would be joining us tonight, and we thought, well, he's in the title fight. He certainly has to, and it's great to see that he has joined. He's going to take the fight to his teammate. But he joined quite a lot later than the rest of the drivers who had been in the server for a good half an hour already. And you can see here he's testing the limits in qualifying. He's run a bit wide. So if he was on a lap there, it's done and dusted. But Darryn Lobb is a very quick driver behind the wheel of the sim. And certainly I'm sure that we'll see him up the pointy end at some point. He might just be testing the limits here to see how this car is handling.
We've certainly gotten used to Darryn Lobb joining at the very last minute and basically doing his practice session and qualifying. But yeah, expect to see him towards the end of the session. He'll just be, as you said, testing the limits for now, and he'll put a fast lap in towards the end. But on screen here, Toby Stent in the Team Simblex Racing car. He's had some great pace as of late, keeping on track with Dion DeGraaf, and he was just a little bit up the road from me last round. So it's good to see Toby having some pace. He hasn't quite set a lap time as yet, but hopefully this will get him a lap time. He was sort of in the low 207s during practice. Let's see what his first lap is here.
Crosses the stripe, and it's good enough for P6, so pretty strong opening account there for the 189, and a bit of news as of recently, just this afternoon as well. Toby Stent has been signed as an official driver for Team Simblex. He was racing as a wildcard entry over the last couple of weeks in the Porsches, taking over from a couple of drivers who regularly from the Simblex stable who haven't been able to join us over the last couple of weeks. And it's great to see that he's officially been signed as a driver, and it should be great to see him in action in the sim, in whatever category he ends up in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, great guy is Toby. He's been doing some NASCAR stuff for Team Simblex and having a bit of a skid in these Porsche Cup cars and doing a bang-up job. But Darryn Lobb now back on the screen. We saw him all over the track before, looking like this lap's a little bit better for him. Through this far section around the back of the track here, it's a real committed corner, that one. And it certainly sorts the men out from the boys. And can Darryn Lobb keep it on track down here this time round? I'm sure he's learned his lesson. Yeah, it's looking much better. And this will be a pretty quick time. I'd expect him to see up in the top five or six by the end of this lap. As we come through this final corner here, very tricky. You have to have a real late apex of sorts. But Darryn Lobb here on the gas, that's much better than what it was last lap. Let's see what he does when he crosses the stripe in a couple of seconds. As Callum Hedge now goes to P4, but Darryn Lobb across the line, he's on the grass.
Oh, that's going to invalidate his lap. That's bizarre there, because he was setting personal best sectors, and that certainly was going to be an improvement. But the 99, another error there early on in qualifying as Callum Hedge goes to P4. Jack Mara in the 690 jumps up to P5. Great to have that name back on the grid for this week. And he'll certainly be one to watch out for, as he'll want to slot straight back into proceedings at the pointy end of the field. He was a regular runner in the first half of the championship with podiums and strong top five results. Even when we had Greg Scully in commentary one week, he was raving about this driver right here. So it's great to see him back behind the wheel of the sim and slotting straight back into the top five.
Yeah, we've seen some performances in the past. He's a very consistent driver up in that top five. And the last time we went endurance racing at Spa, he was up in that top five and battling away. So expect another solid performance from him tonight. As we got on screen, Nathan Anderson still hasn't set a lap time as of yet. Is the championship pressure starting to get to him?
So we're approaching the halfway mark of qualifying. 15 drivers have set registered lap times here in high octane images qualifying. There's definitely more than 15 on track. There's 20 plus here on the grid tonight. So maybe, because it's such a long lap, these drivers just making little mistakes here in qualifying. But the number 70, who we've been so used to seeing on the pole position throughout the course of the season, he's got more pole positions so far than any other driver, more race wins than any other driver. He's been the dominant force all season long. Is he just starting to come under a little bit of pressure here? We'll wait and see as he approaches the halfway mark of that lap. Jimmy Ball here on screen, who's got a couple green sectors here to his name. So the Allports Gaming car threatening here for a top five in qualifying. If he can get through the final corner here cleanly, he does. But it looks like he's going to the pits.
Yeah, fair enough too. But Jimmy Ball, he was showing some pace in the practice session around that sort of 2:06 flat mark. So expect good things from him tonight. As Hunter Robb goes a little bit wide, he has got some green sectors, but that will cost him out of that last corner. Let's see what he does across the line here.
Good and enough he's on for the board. P16. So it looked like there was a little mistake there in the final corner that's probably lost him a bit of time. As you can see there, that's Callum Hedge. Need to get familiar with that paint scheme as he gets out of the pit lane, and he's currently in the fourth spot. Big spread in terms of the top four, the top five really. 1.35 seconds separating the top five, 0.8 of a second between first and second. So Barry Manon is 100% asserting that he wants to be the lead MRP driver tonight, and he is showing exactly that by lapping nearly a second quicker than the next car. And if this is the sort of pace we're seeing tonight, it'll be deja vu all over again, because last time he went enduro racing, he basically lead every single lap away from pole position, and he won the race by about 12 seconds as we put the big wraps on him and he does a bit of a spin. But yeah, Barry Manon is not messing about tonight. It's the MRP series and he is absolutely wanting to be at the front of the field.
There's certainly a couple of sideways moments that we're picking up here and there. I mean, I hope for everyone else's sake that Barry Manon does have a couple of spins during the race just to spice it up a bit. But as you said, James, last time we were at Spa in the endurance racing, he just left the field for dead. And no one really had an answer, and the race was really on for second place backwards. So might be the same again tonight, but we'll have to see what happens. I mean, anything can happen in turn one. It usually does in this NZ Porsche Supercup. But Matt Stevens here, he's on a fly around the back of the circuit here. And he is currently in P3, basically on equal terms with Stefan McCartain. And just a tenth or even a hundredth pretty will get him ahead of him. So on board with him now. He's a little bit wide out of that corner. Don't give up yet. He's got a couple of green sectors at the start of the lap. Middle just seems to fall away a bit, but he's recovering well here, Matt Stevens. Let's see what he does.
He's just dropped it wide there at the final corner, and he's straight into the pits. So that's all done and dusted there for the 73. He's in the lane, and that lap time is done and dusted. So very, very impressive start to the lap, and it was virtually matching what he had done previously in that mid-sector. That little mistake there at the final corner, that won't be the first time we see that sort of mistake happen tonight. Already in qualifying, catching out a couple of drivers. 10 minutes to go, Anderson crosses the stripe and he gets a time on the board, but it's only good enough for P7.
Wow, that is quite surprising. We expect Nathan to be up there with the likes of Stefan McCartain and Matt Stevens. At least he's got a time on the board and he's got something to aim for now, but yeah, championship night. It's all starting to happen now for Nathan Anderson. And like you said, James, he only needs to finish 11th or better if Darryn Lobb was to win, so he just needs to take a couple of deep breaths. He's having a bit of a moment here and there. He just needs to take a couple of breaths and he's going to be all right, but maybe starting to feel a bit of the pressure.
Sort of lap times that Anderson was doing in practice before we went live here with qualifying, as we tick under 10 minutes remaining now in qualifying. He did set a 207 flat in practice. He's just done a 206.7, so he's found 3/10 between practice and qualifying, but he's got to find a bit more if he's going to play amongst the top five. As we see, Barry Manon has got a purple sector there in the middle of this lap, but it's looking like this is an outlap here, so he's sending it on the outlap and using all the track limits there through the high speed turn number 11.
He is absolutely on it. I reckon we should stay on board with Barry for the next lap, because I reckon it's going to be an absolute barnstorming lap. I mean, if his outlap's anything to go by, he is pushing this thing already. So what we need to do for the start of this lap, we need to make sure we get a really good exit out of this corner here. Of course, Barry does. And straight into the pit lane. Okay, so that's the end of that one.
So we'll abort that onboard lap there of Barry. He's going to sit in the pits. That won't be too entertaining. But looks like he's found a bit of time there in the mid-sector. So he is in the lane. Most likely going to put on a brand new set of Michelin rubber for the last 8.5 minutes now of qualifying. And will he be able to improve on a 205.3? So far, the only lap time that he's done in this session, and he hasn't been able to beat it, and neither has anyone else out on track. In fact, the first opening laps from majority of the field are doing well enough now that they're actually maintaining throughout the course of qualifying, because we saw that the first laps from McCartain and Stevens were identical, and they're still identical now with 8 minutes to go. As we see McCartain currently provisionally on the front row of the grid, he's in the fight for third of the championship overall with Dion DeGraaf. DeGraaf is down in the 12th spot. So currently it goes advantage of the crisscross racer. But he'll certainly want to try and find a couple of tenths. I'm not sure if he'll be able to find 8 tenths, but get a few tenths clear between himself and Stevens, because it looks like Stevens potentially has the pace to put himself onto the front row of the grid. We saw that a couple of laps ago in qualifying when he just wasn't able to get the lap together and made a mistake at the final corner.
I'm quite surprised we haven't seen any of the team cars basically teaming up and giving each other a draft down these big straights. because there is a lot of time to be made up in the draft, as we've spoken about in previous rounds. But everyone seems to be very spread out and just doing their own thing at the moment. But you might see towards the end of their session that some of the team cars might start teaming up as such. But we'll see what happens. 7 minutes remaining, and over a lap that's 2 minutes, there's not really that many laps left in qualifying. So we'll see what happens in the next few minutes.
Now, these two cars out on track at the moment, one of them the number 17 Callum Hedge, one of them the 211 of Hunter Robb. These two are good mates, and it looks like there's a bit of a drafting helping hand here between Hedge and Hunter Robb. Hunter Robb's currently down in the 17th spot.
Oh,
and they've both made a mistake there at the first corner. Callum Hedge is on his roof. Thankfully, this is a virtual car this week, not a real car. That would have been a big bill for the team at Ilbamba Motorsport. So he's testing the limits here of the sim car. Luckily, there's a reset button, something that he's not all too familiar with in the real world.
That was a classic instance of the lead car goes off and the one right behind follows them off because he's doing the exact same thing. But those boys have still got a bit of time to head back out and try again. As Anderson now goes back up into P4, that's more like what we have come to expect from Anderson. He's now got himself out of that midfield and back into that top four, which is great to see. But Allport here, we're looking at Allport, another fan favourite. And I had some great racing with him last time around at Watkins Glen, and we even got so close that we even made contact. So
was that that infamous moment down the back straight where you guys tried to go four wide into the carousel?
Well, when we got onto the straight, it was only single file. When we got to the end of the straight, it definitely wasn't. But that's the thing in motorsport. There's four guys went in, and I think only one of them came out. We all have very different opinions of it. So that was last week. This is now this week. And Richard there is currently in P14. And he's got a little bit of ground to make up, but he's got some guys around him. And he's got his teammate Jimmy Ball back this week as well, which is great to see.
Couple of the MRP cars teaming up, so it looks like we are seeing a bit of drafting going between the teammates in the last couple of minutes of qualifying, and that's a rotation there for Darryn Lobb. So whatever help he was getting there from Callum Pratt in the 797 won't be helping him out this time around. So the championship fight between Anderson and Darryn Lobb. Anderson's currently up into the fourth spot. He's got himself onto the second row of the grid. Darryn Lobb currently, provisionally, going to start outside of the top 10 there in the 12th spot and 2 seconds away from the pace of Barry Manon, who is parked in the pit lane, and I would expect to see him remain there for the rest of qualifying as a couple of cars starting to make their way into the pits to get themselves ready now for the final race of the season. 150 kilometres, 23 laps here of Road America. We'll see some pit stops, we'll see some action no doubt, but we've still got 4 minutes now left to go in qualifying. Can anyone improve their times here in the last couple of minutes?
It's going to be interesting. It's for Nathan Anderson's sake, it's good that he's got himself out of that midfield battle and basically up towards the top four, because starting in the mid-pack, I can tell you from experience, she's all on at turn one. And for his championship's sake, it's good to see him a bit further up the field. Toby Stent here is currently the leading Simblex car in P8. And he's got about 3/10 to find to get onto the back of Pratt. And he's, I think he's got Dion DeGraaf there behind him, trying to give him a bit of a tow. So, like we said before, these guys are going to start buddying up and trying to get that little bit of an edge here and there. I think Dion may be a little bit far back to take advantage of that tow. But it's qualifying, you try anything towards the end. So we'll see what happens.
Just under 3.5 minutes now left to go in qualifying. Currently, Barry Manon provisionally is going to get the High Octane Images pole position award and $10 cash for the final time this season. He's got 0.8 of a second between himself and Stefan McCartain. A little bit wide there for DeGraaf, and he's all crossed up there. That's not going to do him any good, as Jimmy Ball goes up into the 8th spot there on a 206.9. So he gets himself under the 207 bracket, as we see Stefan Adams here on screen, the 31. Another fan favourite as well from everyone that tunes in on the stream. He currently hasn't got a lap time on the board, but with 2.5 minutes to go, personal best sectors here. Looks like this is a clean lap here from Stefan. Where's it going to put him? on the board there in 18th spot. So he gets a lap time on the board, and at the moment, that's good enough for P18.
Yep, Stefan, I can tell you from experience before, he just jumped in basically at the start of the session. He hasn't had too much practice around this road in America. Obviously, life commitments as well. But no, it's great to see him on the board, and he'll be hoping for a clean race this time around. And this fast section through the back here, it's going to be great to see on lap one with everyone bowling through there. And we're going to have a great race ahead of us, folks, let me tell you. But yeah, we've still got a minute 50 left to qualify, and then there's still time for people to finish their laps after that as well. So there's still anything could happen here. But let's see what Taylor Bright can do. He's currently down in, where is he at the moment? I don't even think he's on the board, is he?
No, he's not showing here on my timing monitor here. He's showing that he's 20th overall out of 20 cars, and he hasn't put a lap time on the board. So Taylor Bryant is crossing the stripe. Is that going to be a lap time there for Taylor Bryant, or is it going to be a start of a lap? It looks like it's the start of a lap there as Callum Hedge crosses the line, improves on his time, but stays P5. So he's just done a 206.5. And Darryn Lobb slots himself up a couple of spots into position number 10 on a 207 flat. So there's a difference, half a second exactly, between Callum Hedge and Darryn Lobb. That's the difference between P5 and P10.
Yeah, it doesn't take much in the MZ Porsche Supercup. I mean, just a couple of tenths here and there can make the difference. Dave Yeo here on screen. He is currently in the 15th position, just behind Richard Allport. And I can tell you from practice, Dave wasn't exactly a fan of this track, but he was improving with his lap times, which is great to see. And starting 15th, not too shabby. You're looking for a bit of an improvement here as he comes up to the stripe. He's got a couple of green boxes here and there. Can he improve on that lap? No.
So 10 seconds to go here on qualifying. Whoever's out on track completing their laps will get to finish them off, but if you haven't started a lap by exactly now, your qualifying session is done and dusted, and it looks like there's only about three or four cars left out on track. Callum Pratt, Darryn Lobb, Nathan Anderson showing that they're still out on track as well. Ryan Cottrell is out on track as well, but he's just reset back to the lane, and three MRP cars out on track. So too is Matt Stevens, but I think Matt crossed the control line there and he hasn't been able to start a new lap, but he might just be doing a bit of practice anyway as Darryn Lobb resets back to the pits. Callum Pratt crosses the line, currently P7, and he's about 2/10 off his previous best, Nathan Anderson, championship leader, the last one out on track. Whoa. Rotates it. That's going to be the end to his qualifying session, and it looks like it's going to be pole position number two of the season out of two attempts for Barry Manon.
Two from two for Barry Manon. We didn't expect anything less, to be fair. But 8/10 on the field. He's just showing his class once again. He showed it at Spa, and I'm sure he's going to show it again here at Road America. So, like I said, the battle will be on for second place back, unless Barry makes a mistake. But anything can happen, ladies and gentlemen. It's a long race ahead. There's pit stops ahead. And, mate, the championship's coming down to the decider. Who's your money on?
Going to be difficult. I mean, Anderson, he's got over 160 points between himself and Lobb, so he doesn't need to win the race. He's just got to finish inside the top 10 to get the title. But if you're Darryn Lobb, you've really got nothing to lose. You may as well have a crack at it and throw some moves and try and get your way further up the field. But it's going to be interesting because there's almost going to be two different races and two different mindsets going between the two championship contenders. One will be about conservation and maintaining the points buffer, and then one of them will be out there attacking, knowing that he's got nothing to lose, really. He's pretty much got second in the bag already. So, yeah, I can't really... I don't know who I'm going to put my money on. After 23 laps, maybe I'll make a decision.
The safe bet is always, I love it. But, yeah, like you said, Anderson basically just has to finish in the top 10. Lobb is going to be throwing everything at this to get his way up the field. But we saw with Anderson, maybe the, you know, it's starting to get to him a wee bit. It took a wee while for him to get a lap down in qualifying. If I was in his position, I'd just be taking the safe option, let the top three go, and just hold on from there. But we shall see in about 23 laps time, like you said. Have you got your money on a smoky for this race?
Oops, sorry, I think you just cut off there. Wait, I'm just doing a quick reset there. And have we got you, Matt?
I am still here. Can you still hear me?
Yeah, here we go. Okay. No, I've leant on my aux cord and I accidentally unplugged you there. So whatever you just said, I didn't hear any of it, but I'm sure it sounded good.
That's all right. I was just basically asking if you got your money on a smoky this race. Who's going to be the big surprise?
That's a good question. I'm going to say Callum Hedges is certainly going to be up there. I mean, we know the experience and the racecraft that he brings from the real world to the sim. But I don't know. I reckon even the likes of Callum Pratt or Jimmy Ball might throw a surprise. But anyway, we'll let the gambling odds and the bets, we'll let that unravel in the YouTube and the Facebook chat. So let us know who your pick is after 23 laps. But here we go. Qualifying done and dusted. Here are the results from qualifying, and this is how they will start the final race of the season. Manon on pole position from McCartain. Stevens, championship leader Anderson, and P4 Callum Hedge from Earl Bamber Motorsport there in the fifth spot. Jack Mara, Callum Pratt, Jimmy Ball, Toby Stent, Darryn Lobb, second in the championship, has a bit of work to do starting out of position number 10. Dion DeGraaf starting out of position number 11. Kane Crackett, Taylor Oakes, Richard Allport, Dave Yeo, Hunter Robb, and Ryan Cottrell. Stefan Adams, Taylor Bryant, and Greg Barwick starting out of position number 20.
So it is all on now for the final race. One last time for the MRP NZ Porsche Supercup. Look at all those cars lined up there, ready to go. She's a long road down to turn one, as we can see. And if you're Barry Manon, you'll be worried about getting that thing off the line. If you're Nathan Anderson, you're probably even more worried about getting off the line. It's going to be all on for turn number one. And here we go with the lights are on now for the MRP. One last time, NZ Porsche Supercup. The five lights are on and the lights are out and we are away. Great start there by Barry Manon, and Stefan McCartain pulls right in behind. Looks like everyone's got away very cleanly at the moment. Anderson and Lobb have definitely got away, but now what will happen to turn one? Let's watch and find out.
So far, so good. Oh, Dave Yeo is taking to the grass and he's taken out Taylor Oakes and Hunter Robb, I think, as well involved in that one. So it looked like they were trying to go three wide there into turn number one. That does not work on the opening lap of 23 here at Road America, but check out the margin between Manon and McCartain already. He's almost in a safe spot there already in the first spot.
Yeah, heavy braking zone here. Very interesting in this race. These straights are going to bring these boys back into the draft range. But as you say, Barry Manon is away and laughing at the moment. And for championship wise, the boys are safe at the moment. Anderson in fourth position. And Darryn Lobb is back into 13th. He must have lost a couple of spots in the... is he at a half rotation there as well?
And it looks like damage to the front of the 99 as well. It's squirming in a straight line. It looks like he's vulnerable there to Stefan Adams. So what's happened there to the number 99? He's dropped four spots already from the start of this race, and that is another box tick for Anderson. He just needs to stay where he is at the moment for 23 laps. Ooh. Top four have started to break away from the rest of the field. Anderson's got a pretty comfortable margin over Hedge, who's made a clean start, and he's held on to the fifth spot. Anderson a little bit wide there on cold tyres, but so far so good for the first half of the field.
Yep, Nathan Anderson's given me a couple of heart attacks, and he'll probably give me a couple more towards the end of this race. Oh, Stefan McCartain's off.
And that's big as well, because he's in the fight for third in the championship. What's happened there? Has he done that to himself, or was he given a helping hand there? He was in the battle with Matt Stevens. We'll get a read on exactly what's happened there once things settle down and the rest of the field cross the start-finish stripe. One thing's for certain, it's all about Barry Manon out front. But check out the margin here between Stevens and Anderson. It's on between these two down the straight. They're already weaving. How aggressive is Anderson here going to be in the opening stages of this race?
Oh, we've got 22 laps to go. So let's hope for his sake he keeps it nice and clean. That for me, is looking like a pretty good spot to be in, just tucking in behind Matt Stevens and just staying there in P3. We know Matt Stevens is a very safe driver, and he's not going to argue too much, and especially get caught up in any championship drama. But Anderson is in the draft. He is going to be looking to try and pass him already. Is this the right thing to be doing? He goes to the outside. Stevens holds the defensive line and holds the position. Well done there, boys, keeping it clean. Anderson's looking for the switchback, though. Can he get back up the inside to this left-hander? Not quite.
Stevens is going to leave him about half a car length, but it's not enough for the number 70 to get through. And check out Callum Hedge. He is already ranging up in behind these two. They were starting to break away from Hedge, who was actually starting to fall back into the clutches of Jack Mara. But he's becoming part of this battle once again. Barry Manon, as expected, has got a 2-second margin already over Stevens and Anderson. Darryn Lobb continues out on track, and there's a car rotated in the background. Oh. There is Allport, who's been collected in sympathy there by Ryan Cottrell. So a couple of cars down through the field are playing for keeps, and unfortunately there's still 22 laps to go, and these guys are fighting as if it's the last lap of the race.
Yeah, I think these boys need a bit of a reminder that it's an endurance race. But Darryn Lobb there back into 10th position. And mate, in my right ear, I can hear radios going off left, right and centre for sorry, sorry, sorry. So it's all on back down the field here. And I don't even know where to look next. But Jimmy Ball, he's back in the championship in 9th position. He's on the back there of Dion DeGraaf, who's back in the prime position ready to take that 3rd place in the championship now that Stefan McCartain has fallen down the field. And hopefully soon we can get a high-octane images replay of that to see what happened. Because first couple of laps, mate, she's been all on.
3 laps in the books, and we'll start to get a read on exactly the sort of pace that we are seeing from the rest of the field. 205.7 for Barry Manon. He's absolutely skipping away with this race lead. Stevens and Anderson lapping in the 206s and the 206.5 for Matt Stevens, and 206.6 for Nathan Anderson, 206.4 for Callum Hedge there in the 4th spot. Side by side again between Stevens and Anderson. He's got to be careful here, Anderson, that he doesn't get himself caught up in an incident, because he's in the box seat at the moment with Darryn Lobb still down in that 10th spot.
I'm uncomfortable with this, James. It's especially with Hedge now on the back of Anderson, he needs to really work out what his priorities are and keep that eye on that championship. But this battle is just a little bit too close for leading the championship at the moment, as we got Mara now on the back of Hedge, and he's got quite a gap over Callum Pratt. So the top 5, just like in the last endurance race, have really cleared out from the rest of the field. But Pratt here, he's got Toby Stent right behind him. And what a fantastic shot this is to the fast right-hander here, and you don't want to get this corner wrong, because there's a wall on the left-hand side just asking to be hit. But there you go, Barry Manon flashing by. He is gone. See you later. And Stevens and Anderson, Hedge and Mara, it's all on for this position.
So Stevens is doing a good job at the moment. It looks like he doesn't have the pace over Nathan Anderson, or maybe he's just sitting in behind and just... sitting in front rather, and just letting the race come to him. He knows that Anderson's there, and Anderson's not going to make too much of a big move because he's in the championship fight. So Stevens might be in a good spot here. But Callum Hedge, Jack Mara, two drivers that I put my money on at the beginning of the race that could certainly throw some punches here up the pointy end of the field, are certainly doing that. Anderson shows the nose there into turn one, not able to do anything about it. And last time around, again, Barry Manon was 1.2 seconds faster than Matt Stevens. So it just goes to show that clear air is certainly helping out the 118 of Barry Manon, who's absolutely walking away with this race lead. Stevens holding down in the 2nd spot. If Anderson's got anything for Manon, he's got to make a move now.
That is for sure. But at the moment, he's stuck behind Matt Stevens, who, like you said, is doing a great job. Callum Hedge is looking racy here behind Anderson. And if I was Anderson, I'd just be waving him on through. As Anderson is another wee look. He's just having a little look and getting in the mirrors there of Matt Stevens, just to try and get his break his concentration. And that's the way to do it, to try and get past one. He's got a great run, though, out of that right-hander. Is he going to look down the inside? No, Matt Stevens covers that one off again. So it's all on for position number two.
And they're side by side once more as they make the run now through the carousel. And if anything, those two have just got a little bit of a margin over Callum Hedge. Anderson looks the closest he's been here, but you can't run side by side through this sequence of corners. And Anderson's out on the grass. He keeps it in the throttle, gets away with it. He'll get himself an off track for that, but he won't be worried about that. He's going to throw a move down the inside of Stevens, but he's not quite close enough. There's a lockup in the foreground of Callum Hedge. He's made a mistake, and that's Jack Mara through up into the fourth spot. Unforced error there for the 17. And is he going to fall back into the clutches of Callum Pratt and the battle pack in behind? He might just be safe for the time being. But Hedge, a mistake there, and that's put him back into the fifth spot.
Yep, it only takes one mistake around this track, and you can lose a massive amount of time, as we've seen. Anderson and Stevens are now side-by-side going into turn one. That is not going to work by the time they get into the apex of here. They're sort of weaving and bobbing a bit down the straight here, but Matt Stevens does manage to outbrake Nathan Anderson, who tries to throw it back down the inside. Oh, it's so close here at the moment. Anderson is all over the back here of Stevens, and watch out for Mara. He's going to try and look and take the advantage here as well. Anderson back around the outside.
Oh, now contact as well between Anderson and Stevens, and Mara into the back of Nathan Anderson. And there's damage to the front of Anderson, and I think Anderson's put the white flag up and he's getting out of that battle because it was getting a bit too heated for him. And I think those sorts of moves are what is going to determine this championship. Does Anderson fight or does he think about the long run? Because in 19 laps time, if he can stay in P4, he has the championship.
Yeah, that was a very sensible move there by Nathan just to back out of that and let Mara have that position, because if we remember back to the endurance race we had at Spa, Matt Stevens got a post-race penalty for too many incident points, which means going off the track and collecting other cars. DeGraaf sends it down the inside and he's gone.
That's Dave Yeo in the 013 who was all crossed up on lap number one, and he's crossed up again at the start of this last lap. There's Kane Crackett in the lane, the first of the pit stoppers, and I think Richard Allport has made a pit stop as well. And himself and Kane Crackett are the only two drivers out on track that have taken a compulsory pit stop in this race so far. 19 laps to go. Barry Manon is absolutely in command of this race, as he was in the last endurance event. He is leading by 6.7 seconds, and already Anderson's on the back of this battle, but he might just sit in behind Jack Mara and Matt Stevens here, maybe play the undercut to get himself ahead, but he's just going to stay in behind for the time being.
Yeah, as I was saying before that David Yeo spin, Anderson needs to be careful of the incident points that he's got. We've only got 17 incident points to play with here, and if you go over them like Matt Stevens did at the Spa race, you will get a post-race penalty. So a bit of contact here and a bit of grass cutting here and there. It's going to start racking those up with still 18 to go. Need to be a bit mindful and keep that in the back of your mind. But Jimmy Ball, he's back after a few rounds off. And he's on the back there of Toby Stent. And Jimmy Ball had some great pace there in practice. And he's certainly on the back here of Toby. And he'll be looking to put a move on him fairly shortly, I'd say. Here we go.
And he's got a fantastic run there on the 189. And he's going to pull out alongside the 189. Is he going to have enough momentum to get the move done by the time they make their run down towards turn five? Yes, he does. Does that one pretty easily, actually. He gets himself up into position number seven. And the next on his list is Callum Pratt in the 797, who's staying with Callum Hedge. So the two Callums currently holding down fifth and sixth spot. And that mistake there for Hedge, a little mistake, and all of a sudden he's out of that battle pack that are fighting for the last remaining spots on the podium. But don't discount the likes of Hedge and Jack Mara, who is just dropping out of the server. He's falling down my timing tower. Is he back? Oh, there he is.
Oh.
I was seeing his name dropping down, and I thought, oh dear, that's a internet problem there for Jack Mara, but he's still out there on track, which is great to see. He's still holding down that third spot. Anderson in behind with Stevens ahead. So breathe a sigh of relief there for Jack Mara, who's doing a great job there in P3. And at the moment, these three just holding station at the moment. Hedge trying to claw back some of that time that he lost with that little lockup. That's put him on the back foot now. He was fighting for the podium spot, but he's down on the fifth spot now. He's about 1.8 seconds away from Anderson.
Yes, we saw Nathan Anderson have internet problems. I think it was in round one at Hockenheim, where he just literally dropped out of the server and it cost him a race win, basically. But Anderson now is in the draft here at Mary. He's going to be looking down the inside here at turn number one. He has got the speed on him at the moment. Can he pull this off? Into the braking zone. Now he backs out of it, and Jack Morris sweeps across the front of him there. So Anderson playing the safe card at the moment. And to be fair, that's what he needs to do to in order to keep this championship lead. Darryn Lobb still hasn't improved and still in position number 10 as Dion DeGraaf now enters pit lane, chucks some fuel in the Porsche, and he will head out again.
So far, four cars have made their compulsory pit stop, make that number five for Dion DeGraaf. Taylor Oakes was in the lane last time around, and he's made his compulsory stop in this race. Barry Manon, last time around in terms of lap speed, he was exactly a second faster than Matt Stevens. So Matt Stevens has been able to get a little bit faster there in that second spot, but he's definitely not anywhere clear of this battle pack. Second, third and fourth have been a hotly contested battle right from the get-go. It was a four-car battle. Callum Hedge has dropped a little bit further back as we jump back to a bit of action here outside the top 10. Hunter Robb and Taylor Bryant, who have both made pretty good inroads from the start of the race, both making up 6 and 7 spots respectively. Check out this battle here for 11th and 12th.
It's certainly all on here, and we see a bit of damage on the front of Taylor's car on the front left there, so he'll be looking to get that fixed when he comes in for his compulsory pit stop. And we've got Barwick there in behind him in the quality car. They've certainly been a talking point this season. Some great looking cars, and we hope they can come forward to the GT4 season, which is coming up next season, James.
Yes, certainly is. It's going to be an exciting addition to iRacing and the New Zealand sim racing community as we bid farewell to the Porsches tonight. And that was a bit of a feisty move there for Anderson, who got the move down the straight to take away the third spot from Mara. Is Mara going to throw it down the inside at turn number one? No, he thinks better of it. He's going to slot in behind the 70. And all of a sudden, Matt Stevens has got probably the most amount of margin he's had so far this race.
Oh, Mara, that was very close to clipping the grass on the entry there into the turn. And Anderson, that was pretty high-risk stuff down the main straight to cut in front of him like that. But as you said, Matt Stevens got a bit of a breathing room on these guys now. But with this long straight and the draft effect, you're going to see these boys come right back up onto the back of him. It's Stevens, if you're in his position, you just hope these boys start fighting so you can just clear off like Barry Manon has. And Callum Hedge there is still in behind these guys. He hasn't lost too much more. There's a bit of action there in the background between Stent and Jimmy Ball.
Running a bit wide there, and it looks like that Stent through. McCartain, who was around at the early phase of this race, has got himself back up into the ninth spot, but he is yet to make his compulsory pit stop. So far, the leading drivers out on track that have made their compulsory stops, Dion DeGraaf in the 14th spot, and the split between himself and Manon is 1 minute and 6 seconds already between those that have made their pit stops and those that are still out on track. So big spread in terms of track position already, and we'll see a couple more drivers make their way into the pit lane in a couple laps time. But one thing's for certain, it's the Barry Manon show on repeat again for another enduro round, and that gap nearly out to 10 seconds. It's just hovering around that margin at the moment. When is he going to be in the lane for his pit stop? He continues on, so he is electing to play the long game. He's not going to react to anything that's going on in behind. And
here we go.
Pit stops unfolding. Here we go. Stevens and Mara are in. Anderson continues on. So too does Callum Hedge. Callum Pratt is in the lane as well. So too Jimmy Ball. Toby Stent is going to make his way now into the pit lane.
So it's all going to start playing out in the next few laps when these other boys head into pit lane. But Stevens and Mara, your first sort of front runners in the lane. Can Mara underfuel this thing and try and get ahead of Stevens? It'll be a bold call. But we will see what happens to the boys pull into their pit box, make sure they get into the right box. Yep, that's all very good at the moment. I thought Stevens had gone far too forward, but he's done all right.
That's actually a really interesting talking point there. Stevens has aligned his car so that he doesn't get wheel spin on the exit of the pit lane. You can see there, right, he angled the car straight towards pit exit so that he didn't risk rotating the car on cold tyres. And Matt Stevens, it's little things like that, and exactly... And where's Jack? Oh, there he is.
There
so Jack
is.
Marrett, I thought we'd be a bit closer there to Stevens. So Stevens is the big winner in terms of that pit stop. So maybe he's put more fuel in that car. Has Marrett been able to save a bit in that battle pack?
Yeah, so with Stevens now, he's certainly got a bigger gap over Marrett, that's for sure. And that's actually... Oh, who's this off? It is Toby Stent. So we saw him... He carried on for another lap, but he has chucked it off the road. And he is going to be absolutely filthy with himself at the moment because he was looking for that overcut to try and beat those guys out of pit lane. But Barry Manon, he's still way out in front, 11 and a half seconds basically. I'd say he'll be into pit lane this time by. Look at him, he's just so relaxed and can just chuck the car at the apex, not a problem. And into pit lane he comes. I suspect Anderson will follow him through. And good thing for Nathan, that damage will get fixed at the front. So they've got a bit of a quick damage thing they can select. As Anderson now comes into the pits, he's got to make sure he doesn't speed into pit lane here.
And Callum Hedge and Stefan McCartain are both in the pit lane this time around as well. So they'll be looking to get the first of their couple of compulsory pit stops out of the way. Stent in the background as well after that spin is back out on track. And he'll be putting that spin behind him, and he'll be eyes forward now for the second stint of the race. Matt Stevens in the 73 is the first of the drivers that have made their compulsory pit stops. And here we go. This is going to be the talking point. Where is he going to filter back into this race as the contingent of cars make their way out of the pit lane now? And where are they going to be in comparison to Matt Stevens?
He's got
all of them.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Callum Pratt out on track as well. He's going to grab a couple of cars, and he's going to be pretty close there in behind Callum Hedge. So that battle between the two Callums will resume once again in the second stint of this race. But massive gains there for Matt Stevens. He's well clear of Jack Marrett. And Anderson slots back into the fourth spot. But the margins between those three cars have extended dramatically.
Yeah, unbelievable, especially with Stevens and Mara. There was less than a second when they came into pit lane, and now there's basically 2 seconds between them. So has Matt Stevens underfilled a wee bit? Has he been saving a bit of fuel? And the good thing for him as such is he is now out of the draft range, so it's going to be very hard for Jack Mara and Anderson to try and clamber onto the back of him. So that could be quite a smart move there from Matt Stevens. We'll see how it plays out towards the end of this race. And the two Callums back fighting again. So they've basically resumed the battle as we now enter the second stint of this race.
And Jimmy Ball is tagging along with those two Callums as well to make that a three-car fight. So Manon has been able to maintain his lead out front, and if anything, he's going to extend it again, because he's extending it out to 13 seconds now over Matt Stevens, who's now holding down a much more comfortable second spot there over Jack Marra in the third spot, who's been able to gain three positions from where he started. So the 690 doing a good job in his return here for the final round of the season. Championship leader Nathan Anderson sitting in the fourth spot. He might not have enough for the race win today. He's certainly still in the fight for a podium, but he'll have the championship in the back of his mind. If he can stay where he is now, he'll be safe, and he will claim a season 1 2022 of the Manor Racing Products Porsche Supercup Series. Callum Hedge, the wildcard driver, holding down a very respectable fifth spot. So he's using his real world 992 skills pretty well here behind the wheel of the sim tonight in the top five, and certainly putting on a great performance. And here's a bit of a battle between Pratt and Jimmy Ball down the inside at turn number one. Just enough space given between the two. Pratt's going to hang around the outside, but he's on the wrong side for turn two, but he's going to stay there because Jimmy Ball's going to back out of it and maybe think about the draft down the hill and get him under brakes.
Great racing and respect shown by those two guys there. It's amazing what happens when you leave a bit of room on the outside. But we'll see Jimmy Ball here try and draft up again and try and get him down the end of this straight. He's certainly within striking distance. Can he outbreak him? Here we go, down the inside, but not quite. But it's so close between these two at the moment. And one thing I've noticed is Darryn Lobb, our championship contender, down in 11th position, and he's lost a bit more time, if anything. He's about, you know, 5 or 6 seconds off 10th position, so he might have had a bit of a spin somewhere.
Potentially. There for the number 99, who entered this round second in the championship. And halfway through this race, near or about that distance, it's not looking like it's going to go the way of the 99 for the time being. Still 13 laps to go. Absolutely, it's still a long way to go in terms of racing. Such a long track. Oh, a little mistake there for the 99.
Oh, he's
around and he's in the fence. Does he keep it off the fence?
Oh,
he gives it a little bit of a rub. And that's a little mistake there from Lobb. And he's going to lose more time to the top 10 drivers. He's now showing about 50 seconds away from the race leaders and about 30 seconds away from Nathan Anderson. So 30 second difference on track between the two title contenders.
Well, that's the old saying, when it's unite, it's unite. And when it's not, well, you know how the rest of that goes. But Anderson doing all he needs to do to grab this championship win. And Darryn Lobb just needs to keep circulating and hope for a miracle, basically. But Anderson here down to turn number one, chucking it back into fourth gear. And he's just on cruise control there at the moment. He'll be trying to chase down Jack Mara, but fourth position is absolutely fine championship-wise for Nathan. And nice and easy into this next turn, down the long straight, and he's got no pressure behind, no pressure in front. That's the perfect position for him to be in at the moment.
And Darryn Lobb is in the pit lane this time around once again, and it's showing on our timing screens here that he has already made a compulsory pit stop. So what's happening here for the 99? Is this a second stop? It looks like it. And maybe he's going to throw the strategy and take a very early second stop. Or is this a retirement? We'll have to wait and see if he gets back out on track. He's certainly been a star performer throughout the course of the season, but unfortunately it looks like tonight is just not going his way. And he's dropping down the timing tower at the moment. He'll enter back out on track and he will be in about the 18th spot.
Yeah, so disastrous night there for Darryn Lobb. And if I remember back to last year with the NZ Porsche Supercup, he had a bit of a shocker in the last round there as well. So last rounds in Darryn Lobb don't really go hand in hand at the moment. But unfortunately, it's just not his night. And I can see he's still in the pit lane, so it might be good night news for that one. So Barry Manon, he's still out in front, about 15 seconds over Matt Stevens. And we talked about Anderson being on cruise control. Barry Manon, definitely on cruise control at the moment. He's got all the time in the world, really.
And it looked like that was Darryn Lobb, who's just got back out on track. And looks like that was his second pit stop of the night. 11 laps to go now for the number 99. He's got nothing to lose, so maybe he's come into the pit lane and he's got a fresh set of tyres, filled it up to the end, and he's just going to have some fun with it now for the last 11 laps. And there you go. You can see the 118. It's not too far away. He's actually nearly going to go a lap down Darryn Lobb.
Yeah, absolutely amazing. Yeah, who would have thought that as Ryan Cotterill has gone off there into the gravel trap. And that it's probably it's the most simplest paint scheme, but it's probably the most talked about paint scheme all season. I've really enjoyed that one, but he's had a trip through the gravel and he's back on. He's onto the grass, but he's holding it all together all right. So good work there, Ryan.
Try and grab a replay of exactly what's happened there to Ryan Cotterill. Here is your Hike Dynamics replay.
Oh.
And it looks like he was just all crossed up there on the grass and he's kept it off the fence. He's kept the foot in it. Great job. And he's back out on track. He looked like he was in a battle there with Taylor Oaks and Kane Crackett has been able to take advantage of that. He has now moved up into the 12th spot.
I'm not sure if there was contact between those two. It looked like they were fairly close when the replay started there, but either way, it ended up with him into the gravel track. But Matt Stevens here, still in second place, now 16 seconds behind Barry Manon. As we say it again for the about 1,000th time, Barry Manon is just in a league of his own at the moment. And if anything, Stevens has actually increased the margin over Jack Mara, so he's got quite a safe gap between himself and Jack. And another 2 seconds back to Anderson. So the top four have certainly spread themselves out, and those positions are pretty well wrapped up. There's still 10 laps to go. Anything can happen in this NZ Porsche Supercup. And Callum Hedge is rounding out your top five, 25 seconds off the lead from Barry Manon. But the next group starting to heat up a bit. Jimmy Ball has managed to get around Callum Hedge. Callum Pratt. And Stefan McCartain is making his comeback. And he is now on the back end of Callum Pratt.
So this is the battle here for 6th, 7th and 8th spot. Ball, Pratt and McCartain. McCartain, who was rotated around very, very early on in the race. He's making a good recovery drive, and he is all over the back there of the green MRP machine. The 797 there of Callum Pratt. And if he can get a good run here down this straight, he'll be within a chance to take away the 7th spot from Pratt, who qualified 7th, so he's been able to maintain a position there or thereabouts in terms of where he started the race. And a bit of fuel saving looks like there from McCartain just in behind.
He's done a great job. I mean, we talked about the battle he's having with Dion DeGraaf there for that third position. He's managed to get ahead of Dion, who's just over 10 seconds behind him. So McCartan's definitely got third place wrapped up for the moment.
And it definitely looks like there from that vision and that audio there, the number four is trying to save a bit of fuel in behind Callum Pratt. Does it look like he was lifting off the
Pratt's
gas
wide
there down the straight. Pratt taking a much wider line there through the carousel, but he stays in front of the crisscross racer for now as they make their run through the kink. Using all the exit space, you can see there the wheel tracks there on the grass from when the drivers have got a bit too greedy and just run it a bit wide. But so far, so good here in the second stint of this race. Jimmy Ball certainly impressing in that sixth position, up a couple of spots from where he started. And he's doing a good job leading this three-car freight train of cars. And Barry Manon crosses the stripe, 9 laps to go here in the final race of the season. In terms of lap speed, last time around a 207 flat for Barry Manon as he ranges up onto the back of the 99, his teammate. And Matt Stevens was only 8 tenths behind, so it looks like Manon is starting to drop off the pace here, just putting it into cruise control, something that he's been doing throughout the course of the entire race. But maybe he's just backing it right off now because he's got no threats around him. 17 and a half seconds between himself and the second place car. If we thought Spa was a dominating performance here from Barry Manon, Road America is absolutely unleashed the beast.
He certainly has, and he certainly let the drivers know who's number one in this series. And I can see from our YouTube comments we've got a couple of supporters there of Jimmy Ball, and they're all happy about Jimmy making his way up the field. And supportive of him, your boy's up to 6th position. So he's doing great as we look at Toby Stent. And behind him, in front of him, is Dion DeGraaf, who has just come into the pit lane, I believe, to take on some more fuel.
So it looks like there that was the second pit stop for Dion DeGraaf. He gets himself out on track now and gets himself back out on track into the 13th spot. So that's the leading car out on track that has taken their second and final stop, we believe. We believe it'll be a two-stop race, rather. Whether anyone will need to come in and do a splash and dash for a third stop, we will wait and see. We don't believe anyone will, but it just depends how thirsty these Porsches are in this second stint of the race. Manon crosses the stripe that time around, 207.1. So he's very consistent in terms of lap speed and the lead of the race. Stevens here in the second spot, 17 and a half seconds away from Barry Manon. He's about to cross the stripe this time around, and his lap speed last time around, 207.4. So a much better lap there from Stevens, and he's virtually matching the pace now of Barry Manon, but he's 17 seconds away. Is it too little too late here for Stevens in the second spot? Something's happened to Darryn Lobb because he has crashed and he has reset back to the pit lane, and this is disaster here for Darryn Lobb, and that's big damage to the front of that car. He's going to have to serve a tow as well. What's happened there to Darryn Lobb, second in the championship heading into tonight's event, and things have just gone from bad to worse. Here's the second part of it.
So that is basically championship over, I'd say, for Darryn Lobb. We saw Barry Manon put a lap on him. You see him just up ahead there. So what has happened to Darryn Lobb? He's coming down here into turn number one, onto the brakes. Everything seems to be all looking good so far. Has he dipped a wheel on the grass on the outside and rotated around? No, he's looking. Oh, no, Hunter Robb.
Hunter Robb, he was sitting there on the side of the track. What has happened there? He is, has he had his own moment? And is he rejoining the track?
We'll that's unfortunate.
Try and grab a replay there and see what's happened to Hunter Robb, but he's reset back to the pits and he's out of it now. So something's happened there between Robb and Lobb. And that's disaster there for Darryn Lobb. And I'm going back through the replays here, and we'll try and see what's happened here to Hunter Robb. This is what's happened. So he's had his own moment at turn one with the number nine. That's Richard Allport. And in just a moment, he's going to tap the fence. He reverses out of the sand trap. All good so far here from the 2-1-1. And then
so
all of a sudden,
Barry
Manon gets
Barry
through. Lit it up there on the grass. And unfortunate timing there with Darryn Lobb making his way through. I dare say that was not intentional there from Hunter Robb. He was trying to keep out of the way. He did a good job there of letting Barry Manon, your race leader, through. Unfortunate there for Hunter Robb. He's reset back to the pits as well. And it's just a disaster for Robb and Lobb. And officially, Darryn Lobb out of the race. He is withdrawn from the race. And that's going to be the title for Nathan Anderson.
Oh, so unfortunate for Darryn Lobb. But Nathan Anderson, fantastic job. He won't know that as such at the moment. But basically give him the championship. All he needs to do is just finish this race now. But Barry Manon, that was lucky on his behalf that he got there just at that right time before Hunter Robb lit it up off the grass. And he still managed to pull out a extender's lead, I should say, over Matt Stevens now up to almost 19 seconds. But Stevens has done a great job here. He's extended that gap over Jack Mara as well. We saw them extend that in the pit lane, and he's managed to do that on pace as well. So top three, they're all very spread out, but they've all done a great job, and they just need to keep it up as Jack Mara is a little bit wide, and that's bringing Anderson now back into the fray.
Certainly is. So a podium result here in the final race of the season might be not too far away for Anderson, who certainly won't grab the race win today, as we see Mara a little bit wide there again as they make the run now through the kink. Is Anderson just going to put Mara under a bit of pressure here for the final seven laps of this race?
Look,
he's close enough, and he is absolutely closing in the draft there. He's not going to throw it down the inside. He's going to tuck right in behind the number 690, and he's going to force him off the track even. A little rub there between the 70 and the 690. Six laps to go, and it is all on here for the final spot on the podium.
Oh, so if you're in Nathan Anderson's shoes, do you duck into the pits now and try and undercut him? That's what I'd be doing on this pace that I've got. But no, he goes past one more time. Will he try and set him up here into turn one? He's got a fantastic run. He's in the tow. Jack Mara's going a little bit defensive, trying to shake that draft. But here comes Anderson. Can he throw it down the inside into turn one? No, he's playing the safe card at the moment, which is exactly what I'd be doing. Great job there, Nathan. You just need to keep it on the black stuff there, buddy. You're doing a great job. So, I mean, there's a podium right in front of him. He knows what he needs to do. and that is just staying in between those two white lines. But he's a racer. If there's an opportunity, he'll definitely take it. But he needs to edge on the side of caution as well.
6 laps to go. 20 seconds between Manon in the lead of the race. Stevens in the second spot. This is the fight here for third on track. Anderson trying the under and nearly rotates it around. But Mara's on the grass. He's trying to give Anderson some space, and he does. And he is running all sorts of wide there. He's making big mistakes in this third spot. He's trying to hold on to the final spot on the podium. Anderson can't put the move up the inside because the door's been slammed shut. Mara is driving this thing absolutely defensive, trying to hang on here to this third spot. Go back to Callum Hedge, who's is in a battle of his own here with Jimmy Ball, but they're only 5 seconds away from these two if they tangle. Fantastic racing here in the final race of the season.
Jack Mara is definitely on the ragged edge at the moment, but he's certainly managed to keep Nathan Anderson behind him. But Anderson's got a great run through that fast right-hander. Can he look down the inside? No, Mara goes to the defensive line. It's getting very close between these two at the moment. But he is holding on by the tips of his fingernails, that's for sure. He's using every part of the track. It's great to see. And let's just hope, as Manon now comes in.
So that's for his second stop of the night. And it's only 5 laps to go. So Barry is in the lane, and that's going to put Stevens now into the lead of the race. Mara is going to come through and be in the second spot. Anderson in third. Manon in the lane, and he is taking on a bit of fuel here. He's topping up to get home, and he is out. And where is he going to rejoin this race? In the seventh spot, 20 seconds away from the lead of the race, which is now being held by Matt Stevens. And this is the battle here for second and third. Effectively, this is for the final spot on the podium. And now these guys are going to think about when they blink and come and get their final stops of the race done. That was nearly contact between Mara and Anderson. This is fantastic stuff, but they're starting to slow each other up.
Oh, here we go. Anderson now down the inside. He's got the switchback on Mara and throws it down the inside. Oh, that was close to bidding it, but Mara's coming back at him side by side again, but Anderson has got the line, and he's now got that that move done. So you can tick that off the list now for Nathan Anderson. He's back up into a podium position as Toby Sent now is in the pit lane. Gets a bit of fuel and is on his way.
A literal splash and dash there for the 189. I don't think he was stationary for all of 2 seconds getting that fuel on board. So we jump back out to our race leader now, Matt Stevens, for the first time tonight. But we expect that he will be in the lane very, very shortly to get a splash and dash on the board. I dare say, 5 laps of trying to fuel save there on the one stop is a pretty brave call. Manon 20 seconds away. He will certainly be safe there in the seventh spot. So we expect the top 6 cars to be in the lane with 5 laps to go for a splash and dash. We'll wait and see as Stevens continues on once more. He's going to leave that stop right till the very end. Anderson and Mara continue on again. What's Callum Hedge and Stefan McCartain do? They're all continuing on. So are they all going to try and fuel save there with 5 laps to go?
Oh, it'd be a miracle if they could save that much fuel to get to the end. But anything is possible, but I don't think it's going to happen somehow. But I have been wrong before. I may be wrong again. But I definitely think these guys will be in the next couple of laps as Hedge gets a little bit sideways there as McCartain now starts to turn up the pressure on him. Looks to the outside of him. This is going to be a bold move to go all the way around the outside. He tucks him behind for now. Callum Pratt now on the back, and he's got a fantastic run on these two. Look at the gap just close up between these three. Can McCartain get him down the end of the long straight here?
Side by side between Hedge and McCartain. Callum Pratt might be the big winner in this in just a moment. Hedge gets ahead of McCartain, but McCartan's still got an overlap there. He's going to try and throw it down the inside, and he does. They make a little bit of contact, and he forces the issue there on Callum Hedge. Pratt goes through into the fifth spot. And four laps to go, the final four laps of the season, and you'd think that these guys are battling if it was the first race of the season.
It's unbelievable, really, isn't it? I can hear a little bit of chat in my ears from Hedge and also McCartain. I'm not sure if he said he was going to let him back past. We'll have to keep an eye on this at the moment, but I think I heard the word that McCartain is going to let Hedge back past. We'll just have to keep an eye on this at the moment.
Hopefully he's not got confused of the Callum in behind him, because it's a completely different Callum. There's one in behind him at the moment, but then there's a car in behind again that's a couple of seconds behind there in the foreground. So we'll wait and see to see whether these guys readdress their spots. Stevens is in the lane now, four laps to go, and he is in the lane to serve his final stop of the night. Anderson now is going to take over the lead of this race, four laps to go. So when are Anderson and Mara going to come in for their second pit stop? We'll wait and see. McCartain and Pratt now have been elevated up into the third and fourth spots. So this is a great showing here for Pratt, knocking on the door of a podium here in the final race of the season. Barry Manon charging back through the field. He's got himself back up into the sixth spot. Three laps to go, 11 seconds away from the lead. Is he going to be able to do it? We'll have to wait and see. He's been dominating this race right from the get-go. And he's made two stops, and everyone else is going to continue on with one. So there's a big chunk of the field, five cars left out on track, that are going to try and brave it with a one stop. And that raises a few question marks for me. I don't know whether they'll make it, but they've committed at this point, and I guess we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah, it's going to get spicy towards the end of these few laps, that's for sure. Three laps to go. Can you save enough? I don't think you can, but these boys might be able to do it. If I was Anderson, I'd definitely just chuck it straight into the lane. I've got the championship basically wrapped up. It's time to play the safe card and get into the lane. But if you're someone like Jack Mara or Stefan McCartain, you've got nothing to lose, so you may as well just throw caution into the wind and see what you can do. But Manon, we've seen him. He's had 1 or 2 seconds over the field each lap, and he is only 11 seconds off the back of Nathan Anderson. So I wouldn't be surprised if he is going to storm on through. But anything can happen in this NZ Porsche Supercup. We've seen it many times.
And I've just got inside word from the number 70. He believes that he's all good for fuel to the end.
Wow.
So we'll have to wait and see. That would be a big call if he is all good for fuel till the end, because 11 seconds between himself and Manon. Can he maintain that margin? We'll have to wait and see. Is Mara a little bit wide, and he's in the lane with three laps to go.
Oh,
McCartain and Pratt continue on. So the contingent of cars that are leaving it right till the very end are playing the long game. Callum Hedge is going to join them as well. And the top four cars have only made one stop. Barry Manon in the fifth spot has made two. Two laps to go, 10 seconds between Manon and the lead of the race. Is he going to be able to do what he did last time in the endurance race and claim a race win? Or is he going to have to settle here for the fifth spot?
What a way to finish this NZ Porsche Super Cup. It is getting very, very spicy towards the end of this, as Jack Mara now exits the pit lane in seventh position. Still a great spot. But if Anderson reckons he can make it, it is going to be very, very interesting. He's got 7 seconds over Stefan McCartain and Pratt. And Barry, he hasn't made too many inroads on this lap. He's still got a 10-second margin. So, mate, if Anderson can pull this off and do the championship as well, then fair play to him. But these boys, they're going to be, well, I don't know if they're going to be pushing hard or saving like crazy. It's hard to tell at the moment, but Manon, he's now putting a lap on Stefan Adams. So that's a lap traffic at getting out of the way. But still hasn't really made the inroad. Still 10, almost 11 seconds off the back of Anderson with only 1.5 laps to go.
So will we see anyone blink on the final lap? Or will they commit to make it to the very end? We'll have to wait and see. Anderson, as the margin between himself and McCartain is starting to drop down to under 7 seconds now, but he believes that he's all good for fuel. and we're on the penultimate lap now. Next time around, the white flag. This race has been dominated by Barry Manon, but he had to make a second stop for fuel. And the rest of the field in front of Barry Manon in the fifth spot, first, second, third, and fourth, are all playing the risk game. And Anderson crosses a stripe. He is not pitting. And he is going to keep he's going to maintain the race lead here on the final lap. Does he make it home? We'll have to wait and see in a lap's time.
Oh, this is getting unreal. One lap to go. The boys at the front are trying to feel safe to make it home. Barry Manon is in the fifth position. Still 10.5 seconds off the lead. So, if anything, the boys up ahead are still pushing on with this one. So, let's see what happens here.
So far, so good. Anderson's only lost 0.2 of a second to McCartain, who's got bigger things to worry about in behind, because Callum Pratt is trying to threaten on the rear of the crisscross racer to try and get an MRP 1-2 result to round out the series. So Anderson, is he going to play the risk game and try and make it to the end on fuel? The margin's stable between everyone in the top four at the moment. Manon is only now starting to make a bit of inroads. He's 9.7 seconds in behind the lead of the race. He's starting to close up onto the back of Callum Hedge, but we're starting to get towards the second half of the lap now. We've been racing for near enough 50 minutes now in the final endurance race of the season and the final race of the season. Anderson in the lead of the race, the number 70. Is he going to play the risk game in strategy, and is he about to take the number 70 to victory lane for the final time this season and finish this series off in fine fashion? He entered tonight's race as the championship leader, and he had a battle with Darryn Lobb throughout the course of the entire season, and Darryn Lobb has unfortunately dropped out of it, and there to pick up the pieces in the end is Nathan Anderson. He is going to cross the stripe, he's going to take the race win, and he takes out season 1 2022 of the Manon Racing Products Porsche Supercup Series. Stefan McCartain is going to cross the stripe in the second spot. Barry Manon is going to cross the stripe in the third spot. Callum Hedge is going to cross the stripe in fourth. Callum Pratt is going to finish that one up in the fifth spot. Looks like a final lap mistake there for Callum Pratt. And the antics have begun already there on the front straight. Luckily, no more racing between any of those cars as we pick up here on the number 70. He is the champion. Nathan Anderson finishes off the season in fine form with a surprise victory at Road America.
And he's still got enough fuel to do a burnout. Well done, Nathan Anderson. Your season one NZ Porsche Supercup champion, sponsored by MRP, of course. And he has done a phenomenal job tonight to not only pick up the race win, but pick up the championship as well. He's had a dominating performance all championship long, and he is thoroughly deserving of this championship. And who would have thought, with Barry Manon dominating the race so much, that Anderson would come through on a one-stop strategy to absolutely pick up the pieces, really, and take out the victories. And he now burns that Porsche down. He is celebrating with style. He's done a fantastic job all season. So, Nathan Anderson, your champion for the NZ Porsche Supercup.
It's been a fantastic season of racing. And, Matt, you've had a couple of rounds in these cars. And just talk us through how hard these cars are to drive. And, I mean, the super sprint racing, that's one thing. But to do 23 laps around these circuits and these types of cars, it's pretty grueling for these drivers. So to finish in the way that it did, it's certainly fantastic.
Absolutely agree with that. I mean, these Porsche Supercup cars, they're a very different beast to most other cars or race cars that are on iRacing. They're very tail happy, and they're very aero dependent. And I, with my experience in the couple of rounds that I did, it changes lap on lap, and you really got to get yourself into a groove to keep up those consistent lap times and basically keep the car under control. As soon as you give it a little bit of freedom, it'll just snap around, as you saw with me when I was talking you through that qualifying lap on Suzuka, and unfortunately rotated. But Yeah, now these cars have been an absolute blast to drive. It's a shame that we're losing them, but looking forward to the NZ Super GT4 Cup next season. It's going to be fantastic, and there'll still be Porsches in the field, just the GT4 variety. But I'm blown away with Nathan Anderson, how much fuel he's got left. I would have thought he'd run out a long time ago, but he's a deserving champion, and it's been an absolute pleasure to commentate on him all throughout the season.
Yeah, it's certainly been a fantastic season of racing, and let's have a look now at the final confirmed results now for the final race of the season and what's been a fantastic season of racing. And let's have a look and see how the results from tonight's race ended up. It went right down to the wire, but one thing's for certain, it was action-packed all the way through. Anderson crosses the stripe and he wins by 7.1 seconds. Barry Manon there had to settle for the third spot after dominating the entirety of that race. Stefan McCartain there picked up the pieces and was able to, you know, claw back from the beginning of the race and do a really good job there and get himself back into the second spot. Callum Hedge, as part of the wildcard entry, did a pretty good job there in that fourth spot. Callum Pratt holds down that fifth spot as well. Stevens, Mara, DeGraaf, Stent and Barwick round out your top 10. Cottrell, Oaks, Crackett, Adams, Ball rounding out your top 15. Rob, Darryn, Lobb there in the 17th spot, 9 laps down from the leaders of that race. Allport Bryant and Dave Yeo rounding out your top 20. And Matt Hayward, let's start to get the victory celebrations underway now for Nathan Anderson, because one thing's for certain, we've had 8 fantastic rounds of racing and there is only one champion that we can crown by the end of it. And let's bring him now into victory lane, Nathan Anderson. Let's have a chat now to Matt Hayward.
Definitely Nathan Anderson. He's had a dominating season basically from the first round, and we'll bring him into the commentary box now. Nathan Anderson, first of all, congratulations, my friend. That has been an absolute fantastic series you've had. Just talk us through that race from your point of view. It was fantastic to see you come through with the victory.
Yeah, cheers, Matt. Yeah, I wasn't expecting to get the win in that race. There's a little bit of confusion happening on with a bit of fuel strategy and what had to take place in our pit stops, but we'll let that happen with race control after the race. Yeah, still happy as to wrap up the championship in that way.
Mate, you've been an absolutely dominating driver. You've picked up most of the pole awards and basically been the guy to beat all the season. Just talk about your experience throughout the whole championship this season, mate. What's been your highlights? What's been your lowlights?
Oh, yeah, I'd say probably the first round was pretty good, I think. Oh, correct me if I'm wrong, I won the first race of the round, the season.
Yep.
And then just throughout the season, just being consistent, there was a time at Nürburgring where I dropped out and lost a huge ton of points. So I was behind a little bit at the early stages of the championship. But yeah, just being consistent is the main thing in these kind of series where it's eight rounds long, anything can happen. So yeah, just consistency was key.
For sure, man. And is that a bit of redemption from last season? Yeah, you're in contention last season as well, but it all fell apart at Bathurst. Does this make up for it?
Yes and no. I think the competitive level was a little bit better last season with like Hugo and Darryn and all that up front, Kyle George. Yeah, still happy as to win the series. It is, yeah, like you said, redemption, but I still would have preferred to win last season's and this season's.
Yeah, for sure, man. That's absolutely brilliant. And looking forward to the next season will be the NZ Super GT4 class. You're going to come and join us for that as well?
I'm not sure yet. I might have to do a bit of testing in all the different cars, see what's the quickest, and if I'm going to be quick at all.
Oh, mate, I'm sure you will be. But before we let you go and celebrate as the championship, the champion, I should say, who would you like to thank?
I'd just like to give a big shout-out to Barry Manon for supporting the series and us drivers, Darryn, Callum and myself. Yeah, he's been very good and supportive. And thanks to you, Matt and James, for the broadcast and the running of this league.
Great stuff. Well, we'll let you go, Nathan, and enjoy those celebrations, mate. You've done a great job all season, and we'll let him go. So thanks very much to Nathan Anderson. As I said, he's had a dominating season, picking up most of the poles. and pulling out an ace really tonight and picking up the win. So yeah, it's hopefully got our fingers crossed to have him in the next NZ Super GT4 class. But you got to say, James, he's been a dominating figure all throughout the season.
Yeah, it certainly is. It's a great way to round out the season. You know, starting with a race win and then ending with a race win, you can't really ask for a better performance than that, and especially being in the Manon Racing Products sponsored series and to really, you know, be the benchmark driver from the get-go. It's been fantastic to watch, and fantastic racing up and down the field, you got to say, all season long. It's been a great two seasons throughout the course of the last 18 months of the NZ Porsche Supercup. We say goodbye to the Porsche Supercup cars in the next couple of weeks as we make the switch to NZ Super GT4. But you got to say, Matt, after the last couple of seasons of these cars, you know, these cars are going to be up there with some of my favourites to watch. And, you know, never say never, they might end up back on a live stream in the not too near future, but fantastic racing up and down the field, and really a big step up from last season.
Yeah, these cars always provide great entertainment. I mean, just the sound alone of those screaming Porsches, I mean, they bring goosebumps to me, really, mate. I mean, they are a fantastic car, very rewarding car to drive when you get them right as well. And as you said, it's sad to see them go, but we may see them come back for a cameo here and there. But we certainly look forward to the NZ Super GT4 class. And as I said, there'll be Porsches involved in that, just in the GT4 form. But those cars, we've had a couple of races with them, and they race even better than these Porsches. So make sure you don't go anywhere, because it's going to be all on for next season.
Yeah, certainly is. We're looking forward to the next season of NZ Super GT4. And if you want to be part of that season, head over to the NZ Porsche Supercup Facebook page. That will quickly become the NZ Super GT4 page, but our registration link has been posted on our Facebook and Discord platforms, and make sure you sign up, pay your entry fee, and get yourself on the grid, because GT4 racing is at its best, and it should be a fantastic season of racing. And if GT4s aren't your thing, Thursday nights we've got the V8s, the legacy V8s, back on track at the moment as well, because we're bringing them back for the NZ Super V8s on a Wednesday night. That should be a fantastic series as well. Make sure you sign up and pay your entry fee for that one as well, because that will certainly be great to watch. It's always great to get the legacy cars back out on track, and the legacy V8s, still a lot of life left in them, and I think we might even see Matt Hayward himself behind the wheel of one of those cars.
Yeah, you might do. I might have to get the old FG dusted off and do a few laps in that thing. I certainly can't wait to get those cars back out on track. And I had a little bit of a taste of driving for a couple of rounds during this Porsche Super Cup, and it's got the fire in the belly again. So you'll definitely see me on the grid in the new NZ Super V8 class.
Awesome. Great to see you. We'll look forward to that in the next couple of weeks. But Matt Hayward, thanks a lot for being part of the action here for this season, whether it was in the commentary booth here with me or being out on track as a wildcard entry, and even taking our photos thanks to High Octane Images. Been fantastic to have your support for this season. And really, we couldn't have been out on track without your support this season. So I really do appreciate it.
Oh, thanks very much, James, and I'd just like to say a big thanks to all the competitors in this Porsche class. We've had some great racing, as you've seen on YouTube and Facebook. It's been a fantastic season, and of course, a big thanks to you, James, for getting all this organised and joining me here in the commentary box and having a few laughs at me on the way, especially spinning during that that talk through lap at Suzuka. But no, a massive thanks to you, mate. You do a great job with these series, and we certainly can't wait for the next season to come on board.
Yeah, certainly looking forward to the next season of racing. And a big thank you to everyone who has tuned in to our live streams over the course of the night and the season. In fact, it's been a fantastic season of racing, and we've really enjoyed your company every week. Big thank you as well to Barry Manon and the team at Manon Racing Products for jumping on board as our series naming rights sponsor for this season. It's been great to have their support as part of our championship season in season 1 2022, and we have really enjoyed seeing the MRP cars out on track dominating, really, and even seeing Barry in the field as well certainly putting on some pretty good moves and dominating performances by himself as well. And don't forget, if you want to be part of the next season of racing, sign up and pay your entry fee for NZ Super GT4. You can grab yourself 5% off V&M products at Manon Racing Products as well. Just let Barry and the team know that you signed up for NZ Super GT4 and he'll hook you up with a 5% discount. So make sure you all go and take advantage of that one. So that brings us to a close here on the NZ Porsche Supercup Facebook and YouTube pages. We'll be back in 2 weeks' time for NZ Super GT4 and NZ Super V8s. And we'll be back on the NZ Sim Network as well in 2 weeks' time. So make sure you go and head over to that page to stay up to date with all the latest streams for the next season of racing. Big thanks to everyone for tuning in tonight. We'll see you in a couple of weeks for the next season of racing. We have certainly appreciated all of your company and look forward to seeing you back in action again in just 2 weeks' time.